to A14. Today I'm off to junction 58 of the A14, which is known locally as the Seven Hills Interchange. Have you ever wondered why Seven Hills is called Seven Hills? After all, there aren't too many hills in this part of Suffolk. Well, this is what I'm going to find out, and to do that I've got to come off the A14 and go on to the old A45. So here we are in the lay-by at Seven Hills, and I'm going to park up and go out on the search of hills. The area known as Seven Hills is broadly the area bounded by the railway and the A14 in Nacton. It's mostly woodland, and go into it and you'll discover what Seven Hills is all about. And here we are at one of the Seven Hills, which is right behind me. Blink and you'll miss it. This mound is scheduled by English Heritage and goes by the bland number of 1011451. It's not very high, just over 2 metres. And it's one of 13 listed mounds at Seven Hills, the area being described by English Heritage as a Bronze Age cemetery because these are burial mounds. And they date from between 2400 and 1500 BC. In other words, what we can conclude about Seven Hills is that the mounds aren't hills, and there aren't seven of them. The mounds themselves are called bowl barrows because they resemble upturned bowls. These are common in Suffolk, and around 10,000 have been identified in Britain. The vegetation here means that we can't see the structure well. But in Martlesham there's an excellently preserved bowl barrow called Pole Hill. It's just off Foxhall Road, near the Ipswich Borough Dump. Here at Seven Hills, archaeologists have identified the remains of some 13 barrows, but a few of them have been degraded during the last couple of thousand years of human occupation, and they're barely visible. There's evidence of barrows having extended all the way from Seven Hills to the barrows at Levington, which are shown on this air photo. They could have marked some kind of boundary between tribal territories. Bronze Age bowl barrows usually have one burial with them, possibly reflecting high status. People were often buried with a variety of grave goods such as pottery, jewellery, arrowheads and the like, and these could be made out of stone or bronze. They were all items that reflected the people's status in life and to accompany them in their journey to the next world. In later bowl barrows, there was a change in funeral practice as people's ashes were buried in urns rather than their bodies being laid to rest. I haven't managed to turn up any information about what was found in the barrows at Seven Hills because most of the excavations were done in the mid-19th century when features like this weren't protected and archaeology was rarely professional or properly recorded. So what was so special about this area for someone to use it as a cemetery? The short and simple answer to this is that the land use in this area is predominantly heathland because they're very light sandy soils. The soils are good for grazing but very poor for growing crops, but the earth is light and easy to shape into mounds like these. Heathlands in this area are also slightly elevated, so the mounds would be conspicuous in the landscape. And as I mentioned earlier, cemeteries often mark boundaries between territories. In recent years, it's been left to revert to woodland at Seven Hills. The mounds and any artifacts that may have been found were a symbol to the life and importance of the person and a commendation for the person as they proceeded through to the afterlife. The notion of an afterlife is common in most societies. Some idea of an afterlife and a spiritual world is more prevalent than atheism even in our own society, where a significant number of people still believe in God and or an afterlife. We have no idea what the Bronze Age people actually believed about the afterlife. It's lost in time. The afterlife is something most people today find mysterious. There are many ideas about it, and many people attempt different ways of trying to work out what it's about. But stop and think. Rather than leaving us to try and work out the future as best we can, surely a loving God who cares about people will make himself known to us. He has. In the Bible, the Apostle Paul says that God has made known to us the mystery of his will. And where is this mystery revealed? It's revealed in the word God has given us, in the Bible. And through Jesus, we can understand not only about the afterlife, but life now. Why not check it out for yourself today? Well, thanks for listening, and God bless you.